Welcome to the 2017 Lancaster Archery Classic. This is the Trueball XL Archery Hall at the Spooky Nook facility just outside of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. I'm here with my host, Teresa Johnson.
Hey, Chuck, how are you?
Good. Glad to see you again.
Glad to be back here for our finals starting at 1 o'clock this afternoon with live commentary.
Yes, we will get some of the matches out of the way, and then there's another broadcast again tomorrow for some of the more medal matches. I want to give a huge shout out and a huge congratulations to what an amazing facility and the crew that put this all together, the Lancaster team. They got here on Thursday night, and they've completely transformed a field house into a world-class archery stage.
Absolutely, and when we look at the level of competition that we have here at the 2017 Lancaster Archery Classic, to see this finals venue and the best competition in the world gathering here at this venue to come on down and see how they can put some pressure on themselves and their competitors to hit the 11 and maybe the big cash prize.
Oh, yeah, they can totally cash out here. This is the Hoyt live feed for the shoot-offs. Again, this is the Lancaster Archery Classic at the Trueball XL Archery Hall at Spooky Nook Sports Complex, just outside of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And we're inside. It's warm. It's beautiful. Great conditions.
We've got 1,093 archers down to the top four or eight in each division. Absolutely amazing, and we're excited to have everybody join us this afternoon starting at 1 o'clock.
Tune right in.
Why do the number one archers in the world choose the proven brands of Trueball Release and Excel Sights? Because they want to win.
I will prevail.
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 And welcome back, Teresa. It's going to be a great afternoon. We're here for the shoot-up finals at the Lancaster Archery Classic here at the Trueball XL Archery Hall at the Spooky Nook Sports Complex just outside of Lancaster, Pennsylvania for the shoot-ups for this afternoon for the 2017 Lancaster Archery Classic. And after this morning with the shoot-ups, the qualifications and eliminations that we had, it's going to be a banner afternoon. I'm really looking forward to some great shooting.
Yeah, me too, Chuck. It's such a world-class finals venue here. Very exciting. We've got some archers headed out in just a minute, and we're going to go ahead. And we've got the archers, I think, on their way out right now. And the first matches up today are going to be in the Youth Recurve Female Division. Very exciting. So we'll go ahead and take a look and see who's about to come up to the line now. And it looks like we are going to see Lindsey Bouffard shooting against Whittney Jensen in this first match.
This is youth recurve female, age 11 to 17 years old.
So let's talk a little bit, Chuck, about, first of all, the equipment that these young ladies are shooting. So, you know, what makes somebody a recurve archer or a compound archer? Well, the answer is in their bow. So the recurve bow is the bow with the elongated curved limbs. We call it a recurve bow because the limbs on the bow actually curve back. And you can see that's a great visual of that curve right there. Other, you know, elements of the bow that are very important, you can see the stabilizers in this shot. So on a recurve bow, archers tend to use one long front stabilizer that goes out in front of the bow, helps to balance the weight of the bow and steady the sight, and then two bars off to the sides bringing the weight back towards the archer, counterbalancing the sight and the front bar. Those are called V-bars or side rods. And the center section of the bow, you can see there, is a she has a white riser, which is the center section of the bow that she's going to hold. And then you will also see that she's got an aiming device attached to the bow, which is called a sight. There's an aperture that's on that sight, which the archers are going to use to aim. Now, if you notice on this sight here, it's fully adjustable, which means that the archer, they say the archer's arrows are hitting a little low, the archer can move the sight aperture down, which will actually cause her to aim a little bit higher and correct where she's hitting on the target. So these bows, fairly simple to learn to use. They may look a little fancy, they're not intimidating, they're fun and easy to use, but this is high-tech equipment and really geared towards helping an archer to perform their very best.
It truly is, and this Olympic recurve or this youth recurve, this is what you would commonly see on the international competition and in the Olympics. We don't use compounds. The struggle to the recurve is there's no rear peep to use as a secondary aiming device. You only have the front aperture that you try to place on the target. We're going to go out to Rob Caulfield here on the floor for introductions.
Our youth female division, we've got Whittney Jensen and Lindsey Bouffard. Lindsey Bouffard shooting against each other. Go ahead and take the stage, ladies. Who was third seed? Fourth. Who was third and who was fourth? Third? Okay. You want to shoot first or second? Okay. Whittney Jensen chooses to shoot first.
Go ahead. They were doing there, what Rob was doing there, is depending on your seed.
The way this is going to work, folks, you see the clocks are set at 30 seconds. So Whitney, once the whistle blows, Whitney's going to have 30 seconds to shoot her arrow. As soon as Whitney's arrow hits, Lindsay's 30 seconds will start. She'll have 30 seconds to shoot, and it repeats through three arrows. At the end of the three arrows, our staff will score the arrows, and our staff will pull the arrows and bring them back. The archers stay on the stage the entire time.
This is a little different from most archers in that they're standing on an elevated stage in front of a seated crowd. It's a darkened room. Only the targets are lit up and only the archers are lit up. For these young archers, this is a very high pressure situation that they have probably not encountered before unless they've been to this tournament or a special European qualification type event. So I would expect to see quite a bit of pressure here for these two young ladies to kick off the first round.
Absolutely, and Whitney here, so we see her grip her bow and hook her bowstring. She's gonna draw that bow back, and as she is, she's gonna steady her sight picture, pull through with her back. Beautiful opening shot from Whitney. And actually, the pleasure of meeting her yesterday, she's coached by Dick Tone, and again, another good shot by her opponent. Whitney is coached by Dick Tone, who's one of the preeminent recurve coaches in the country. Also, I think, has been a past head coach for the Canadian Olympic team. So Whitney is certainly in good hands. Let's see how she does.
Comes off with a 9 on the first arrow and 8 on the second arrow.
Let's see how Lindsay's doing.
And they match 9 out of the first arrow, her second arrow also an 8. That first red ring scores 8 points. And when we look at the scoring, the archer only needs to touch the next inside line to get the higher score. That'll also score a 9 on her third arrow.
These are really good groupings and good openers from these young ladies. And that's out to the 7 ring, so that's going to put her at a deficit to start this match. One of the cool things for the folks at home to notice is that, of course, you see that these archers have really color coordinated not only their clothes, but their accessories and their bows, their fletchings on their arrows. Now, this is not just for kids to do, right, Chuck? So we know that everybody who shoots a bow that we know, and actually I think we're going to cut out to Rob Caulfield, who's going to, looks like he's going to chat a little bit here.
She sounds
congratulations on being here.
That little nervous laugh.
And Lindsay, where are you from?
New Hampshire.
New Hampshire. Away from New England. Thank you for coming down.
So the
okay, we've got 26 for Whitney and 25 for Lindsay. Whitney's still up as the leader if she chooses to shoot first.
So the way that the scoring works here in this particular event is it is a cumulative score versus set scoring, which is pretty common in the recurve game, yes?
Yeah, that's correct, Chuck. So normally in recurve competition, archers shoot three arrows, and if they have the higher score, they get two set points. If they have the lower score, they get no set points, and if they tie, each gets 1 point. And this proceeds until one archer has earned six set points. In this case, here at Lancaster, we're doing a cumulative score for 12 arrows. Now, we saw Whittney just let down, meaning she brought her bowstring back to the bow. She didn't feel confident in the shot. Let's see if she gets it this time.
Which is tough, because she only has 20 seconds to get that shot off. And when I saw she went back to draw, she only had a few seconds left to really get that going.
And that can create a lot of anxiety for the archer, because what they're also waiting for, you could see a clicker here on the bow. So you might be saying, what's that little metal rod? That actually drops down as the point of the arrow passes through it. It drops down and tells the archer that it's time to release. Archers are very trained to release on that clicker. It's such a trained response that it is almost impossible when an archer hears a clicker not to release the arrow. So you have to have a tremendous amount of self-control to let down, especially if you come past the clicker.
That's another eight. Oh, and a seven.
And a seven.
Now, if she could have capitalized there, she could have tied that match up for the overall score, but she'll still be a deficit 1 point down.
Whittney has a 1 point lead at this point.
2 point lead. 42-40 for Whittney over Lindsey.
We'll see if she can pull it off.
Beautiful recovery.
Nice shot, just above the 10 ring. It's a nine. Nice shot, gold, nine.
So
great shooting, girls. Let's give them a hand.
Great shooting out of the second end for those girls. See if the nerves work.
That's going now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good job. Put that last arrow right in the goal. Nice shooting, Whittney.
Thank you.
Keep her going, girls.
Nine, seven.
You can tell these girls are nervous, but they're trying
waiting
to perform extremely well. Whittney is up by two unofficially. Two, 51-49. You see the judges up there giving it a good solid look, and the archers have an advocate up there that pulls their arrows for them and returns them to the stage.
Okay, it looks like they tied that end, so that means that Whittney would still have a 1 point edge going into this end. Whittney, do you still prefer to shoot first?
Yes.
Okay.
Whitney's going to retain the position to shoot first. And as a leader, you have that option to defer and shoot second. You can see right there, Teresa, she flips the clicker up out of the way, puts it back down on the way of the arrow, so she hears that audible click, and she knows when to release the arrow.
That's correct, Chuck. And you can also see another important piece of Whitney's equipment there, and that's her finger tab. So on the hand that draws the bowstring back, you notice that she's got some apparatus there. It's actually a couple of pieces of leather that separate her fingers from the bowstring and ensure a smooth release each time. And over here, we've got Lindsey with a nice strong shot and a solid 10.
I believe the score
that'll
is tied
bring
now.
Her right back into a tie match now.
These two young ladies are really showing us how it's done. Really strong shots under pressure. Look at that.
Probably going to be a
left
nine.
For that?
Camera angle kind of gave it as a just out, maybe. Back to back. That's going to be an 11,
Whittney
more
shot
than
a
likely.
10, and Lindsey comes back with an 11 to take the lead.
So now Whitney's got to have her game face on, and she loses
that's
that one
eight.
A little bit. So now
looks
this
like
is a great example of how pressure can play a strong role in archery competition at this level, because
wow.
The archer really, look at
a
that.
10, just out. Wow.
Fantastic
nice
shooting, world-class shooting from Lindsey Bouffard under a lot of pressure. She really just delivered when she
girls
had to.
Starting to get dialed in
you
now.
You can see that swing
right?
There. She definitely got
before
much
you know,
more comfortable on that, looked much more
having
intense.
A good time up there?
Yeah.
You're looking good. Nice shooting. Great end.
Now this is going to be where the pressure comes back to see if she can repeat that. She's got a little bit of a lead going into the final here. She's up by three into the last end, 80-77.
And the key here is for Lindsey to not get in her own head. If she starts to think about whether or not she can repeat that, she's going to really struggle. And the things that she can struggle with primarily are the timing of her clicker. Is she pulling through solidly like she normally should?
Give our runners Colby and Hayden a hand.
Yeah,
good
she
job,
definitely
guys.
Looked like she had good timing going through that. All those shots
okay,
seem to break
the last
roughly the same
end of,
time frame.
Regular scoring. Looks like we've got 80-77. Three-point advantage, Lindsey. Lindsey gets to choose first or second. She will go first, she
says. Lindsey's going to go first, and she's going to put the pressure on her right now to perform.
Now, she had the advantage and the opportunity to choose the shooting order, and she switched her shooting order, so it'll be interesting to see if that plays any role in how she does. Does it give her confidence? Let's see if she can move through or if she's going to tell herself to try to shoot 10s.
Great shot.
Well, guess nice what? Shot. Whether she told herself to or not, she delivered a 10. Nice shooting under pressure.
And she's dialed right in. She's hitting the same zone of the target that she was hitting just a moment ago. A little bit low there for Whittney.
Just low.
So that turns it into a 6-point lead now.
When we're watching recurve shooting, the things that we're looking for is strong back tension. So in other words, does the archer pull through with really strong, a nice strong draw and good release and follow through? And of course, their bow arm, the arm holding the bow, does it stay straight as the bow is leaving, the arrow is leaving the bow?
Mm-hmm. Great looking group there. She's got two arrows next to each other. And this could be the win. That's a nine.
Solid nine.
So at this point,
nice shot for Whittney.
Whittney can't win the match. But she can finish strong and leave on a very high, confident note. Excellent
nice shot.
Let's give these girls a hand.
Very nice shooting by both of these ladies.
What boys up on stage? Well, congratulations. How are you feeling now?
Feeling pretty good.
Very nice. Both of you girls shot incredibly well. Very poised. Look great up here in the lights. What do you think? We ever come back?
Yeah.
Do you like this?
Yes.
Looking forward to doing this again?
Yeah.
We'll look forward to seeing you in a year. All right.
Look at that big smile.
You girls can step down from the stage.
Just fantastic shooting from these ladies, Chuck. You know, one of the things that
we
see is
our next match.
Remarkable
Lindsey
boys under pressure. If either one of these ladies has Olympic dreams or is hoping to make a U.S. team or a youth team someday, that's the number one quality they need is a really strong mental game and the ability to keep their head under pressure. Both of these ladies just demonstrated that today.
Thank you very much. You have anything to say to your friends and family?
Just say I love them and thank them for supporting me.
Great.
Thank you very much. Let's give Whittney a hand. Thank you, Whittney.
This is a great experience for those girls. And now, Lindsey being the winner of that match, she gets to, Lindsey's going to stay on the stage there. She elects to stay in her same position. And Alyssa Artz will be her next match. And the way that this event works is you shoot, you win, you stay, and the next competitor comes up to meet you on the stage. So now we have Alyssa Artz. She's coming up also from the USA.
Go ahead and step up, girls.
And it looks like Alyssa is shooting with the Lancaster Joad team.
Archer coming in, would you like to shoot first
pretty
or
good,
second?
Pretty good team to be associated with. Rob
Alyssa,
and his whole crew down here, they do an amazing program with their Joad.
Right.
It's a huge program.
Go get them, girl. Okay.
She might be a little more comfortable. You know, she's shot around Rob for quite a long time, and these guys practice these kind of events. The judge in the middle, Larry Wise, giving Rob some counsel to make sure that we have everything.
Excuse me, one moment. I remain corrected. Would you like to shoot first or second?
First,
okay. Alyssa is the higher ranked archer. Thank you, Larry. Alyssa is the higher ranked archer coming in. Alyssa was ranked second. Okay.
So Alyssa,
Alyssa will shoot first. Again, 30 seconds. She has to shoot her.
So we've got two strong young shooters here coming up to the line, and it looks like Alyssa, of course, has been part of the Lancaster Archery Joad program. So you might be thinking at home, what is Joad? Well, Joad stands for Junior Olympic Archery Development. It's a nationwide youth archery program for beginners, intermediate, and advanced shooters that is held at clubs and pro shops all over the country. It's a USA archery program. And here's Alyssa with her first shot. Let's see how she does. Really nice, steady draw from this young lady. And it's a 6, so it's a little bit of a tough start to her match here.
Now, and this is where Lindsay's definitely going to have the advantage because she's kind of warmed up. She didn't have to move off the stage. Now, Alyssa could have bumped her off of that stage and taken her position to kind of bump her off her game a little bit.
Let's see how Alyssa does. Good strong shot nice with a nice nine.
Nice recovery. Gives her sight a little bit of a click there to adjust for it. So maybe that first shot was a little bit of nerves, you think?
It very well could have been. And look, now we answer now with a six from Lindsey. Right, that means the door is open for Miss Alyssa.
She can put together a great shot here and put a little bit of pressure on Lindsey.
She's very smooth coming through that clicker. If you notice the point of the arrow, that's an 8-9 liner that could be out. Could be out to the 8, we're not sure, but remarkable, really smooth draw.
We have a 7, just a little bit low. Okay, the judges will make a determination to see where we are for the end.
So that's going to put Alyssa unofficially 23-22 over Lindsey.
Nervous.
All right.
We love it, a truthful response.
And she responds that she's nervous.
All right. Looks like you've gotten dialed in there. You're getting ready to go these next 3 outs. Wish you well. Lindsey, still going good up there?
I think so.
All right.
She can tell she's getting a little more comfortable. You remember the first few words that Rob spoke with her. How nervous and kind of giggly she was, that she was really timid.
Lindsey, what
you can tell
Joanne
he's definitely feeling a little better
now. Do you shoot out of?
Mm-hmm. Pioneer Joanne.
Pioneer Joanne, and what town is that in?
Dunbarton, New Hampshire.
Dunbarton, New Hampshire.
Now,
give
again,
them a big shout out.
She referenced her home Joad club. So these Joad clubs don't exist just in your major cities. They exist in clubs and organizations all across the country.
Absolutely. Okay, whether you live in the country or the city, there's a Joad club near you to check out. And, of course, many of them are run through archery pro shops, okay. Which is actually the best place to get started if you're looking to find out more about how
Lindsey.
To get started in archery.
So Alyssa will continue to shoot first if she chooses. She'll shoot second.
Okay. Oh, she's going to change it
up. Change in strategy from Alyssa Artz.
She's going to try to put a little bit of pressure on Lindsey to perform with her first arrow here, knowing that she missed a little bit wide on her last one. And you can hear how quiet it is in here. The audience is so respectful.
She delivers, man. Nine under pressure. Let's see how Alyssa does. And a nine.
Another nine, yep.
Very fierce from these young ladies. Lots of composure right now. Look how steady she is coming through the shot. She pulls that bowstring back, and it's an 11.
Great shot.
Is that an 11, Dakota? That caught the 11 line.
Similar to the last match, because Lindsey seems to get a little bit of a slow start.
See that clicker?
Ooh. And Alyssa puts it out high. So she caught the 8.
I think it'll be an 8. She's a little high, but she caught the 8 line there.
And a beautiful, nice 10. Beautiful group from Lindsey, who gets warmed up all over again, and now she's going to be tough to beat.
Nice look at her release there, the kisser button.
And that kisser button, ooh,
nice solid
10.
Comes back with the 10 of her own. Let's give these girls a hand.
So the little button that's on the string that's coming up against.
Feeling good up there?
All right. A shot of Rob's daughter there smiling in the background.
Alyssa, that last shot was very nice. Feeling good, nice and relaxed. Starting to relax now. Believe it or not, the pros say the same thing when I ask them how they're feeling up there. Okay.
It's just a slim lead, only 2 points.
I will say, too, remember that the female youth recurve archers are all grouped into one age division, 11 to 17. So
that's a huge spread.
Right. So normally these archers are stratified into, up through the age of 12, then, 13 to 15, 16 and 17, then 18 to 20. So I think we have the situation here with an archer who's definitely, looks like Alyssa's definitely a little bit younger than Lindsey. Whether that should or does play a role, who knows, but it's something.
We have a high 8.
A little bit tall for an 8 there.
What's also putting some pressure on these archers is they are hearing their scores as they go. So one thing that coaches really teach, especially these young recurve and compound archers,
she picks up another point,
is to not know their score while they're competing and not think about it. Well, here, they can't help but think about it.
Yeah, because it's being broadcast right into your ear through a PA system.
Absolutely. That puts a little more pressure on. Nice, strong shot from Alyssa. And she delivers a high 8. So if you notice,
pressure there on that bottom finger.
All of those arrows in Alyssa's target, except for one, are above the middle of the target. So if I'm Alyssa, I might consider.
Whoa, there's a big shift there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think Alyssa needs to probably make a sight adjustment. We'll see
if
she actually does.
I might consider moving my sight if I'm Alyssa.
Alyssa.
Yep, nice solid nine. Now this is going to turn the match.
It looks like Alyssa's definitely got to make a sight adjustment. The question is, will she do it?
Alyssa, that was some very nice shooting under pressure. Way to go. You are starting to relax. Nice shooting. Have anything to say?
No.
I love it.
I don't want to talk to you. I just want to shoot.
Lindsey, last end. You've put some great ends together here during these matches. I'm sure there's more in the tank.
No.
Got anything to say?
No.
No, it's all about getting
She's
it done
good.
Now.
She's good.
Now, there was a turn
are
here.
Are we having fun out there in the crowd? Is this a good time?
So this is a wonderful shot here of the grip on the bow. And what we're seeing here is where the archer holds the bow. So they actually place their hand in a very specific position to line up a pressure point at the base of the thumb with the grip on the bow. And that helps the archer to line up all their bone structure right behind the bow. So let's watch Lindsey do this now. She basically places her hand in the grip. She's going to adjust her hand a little bit, and let's see what she does. So there's that upper body alignment. She's lined up right behind the bow, and a nice strong release for a solid nine. And here's Alyssa, also lined up behind her bow, and a 10.
That'll be a 10.
This is going to be a good match.
Alyssa now with an unofficial 2-point lead, and a nine. Alyssa.
Ooh, and that's a low 8.
That should tie it.
1 point advantage, Alyssa.
Right through the clicker, and boom, she shot a 9.
Nice
that's
nine.
A really nice way to finish this match.
Absolutely.
Let's see what Alyssa does.
9.
Very strong answer.
9 to match. So I believe unofficially Alyssa Artz
will win by one, or should.
We'll wait till it's official.
But they tied on that end,
but
27 apiece.
Like Alyssa Artz has won the match.
We see here that
Lindsey, you put together a lot of very, very nice ends with triple golds. You had some incredibly tight groups there. Very, very nice shooting. We'll wait for an official result. Okay. The arrows are being pulled, so I'm going to assume that that's official.
They both
very nice
up.
Shooting, Lindsey. Congratulations. Let's give Lindsey a hand.
Nice job by Lindsey.
Lindsey from New Hampshire.
And you can see she
Thank
got a little
so
bit,
much.
Or Alyssa got a little bit stronger through the match. She opened up with a 23.
Alyssa, do you want to remain where you are or go over there?
Stay where I am.
She wants to stay where she is. Okay, the next shooter will be the number one ranked shooter, and the next shooter will have their choice. I'll get with the program eventually here. Thank you. I just asked just in case.
It's great that Rob gets to have this interaction with the archers and help them out with everything that's going on. And
she's not late. I'm nervous too.
Now we have our next archer coming up to the line.
Nice shooting.
From, I believe, Smith Point Joad in Long Island, New York, if I'm not mistaken.
And fans out there.
I seem to recognize those green shirts.
Mm-hmm.
And we really have, I think, two young ladies who potentially maybe are a little closer in age in this match. We'll see.
Okay. We have Lianna Pottgen. Pottgen. Okay. Do you prefer to shoot on the left here? Okay. And do you prefer to shoot first or second? She prefers to shoot second. Okay. Ladies, get ready.
She's got a coach advocate in the box.
Correct. And, you know, you have to wonder at this point, you know, for Alyssa, she's the hometown girl. She's got some of her, probably her family and friends in the crowd there.
Mm-hmm.
So is that more pressure or does it help her? And oftentimes that can go either way.
Hers will start.
I think so. I think it's interesting that none of the other archers have brought an advocate or a coach behind the line with them, except for Lianna.
Mm-hmm. So we'll see how she does.
Great shot of her gear there.
And you can see that bead that she's bringing close to her lips. That's called a kisser button. Some archers use that, myself included, to ensure consistency in terms of the head position and where you're bringing the bowstring to.
And it's matched.
And Lianna out for to a good start there with a nice strong nine. Both archers tied in this match after the first arrow.
Okay, we've got a seven, just a little bit to the left.
That was a big seven.
Lianna comes back.
Can't see that one, but it looks like a
nine. Yep, she caught the top of it there. You can see the difference in the style of shooting as well. So when Alyssa finishes, she brings her hand right back along her jaw, tries to stay pretty close. Her bow arm is dropping, which you know, may or may not help her. As long as she's consistent with it, it doesn't matter too much.
Lianna comes through with a 10.
That's a 10.
Lianna really just delivered. Now you'll notice when Lianna releases, her hand comes out a little bit more. And again, this is one of those can help or hurt type things. She's got to be very consistent with that release.
Lianna, how are you feeling up there?
I'm feeling pretty good.
Great. Looking good up there. Nice strong start. Alyssa, things are going well. You're putting some arrows in the gold. It's looking good. Keep it going. Have anything to say?
No.
I know this guy will have something to say. Alyssa's archer's advocate is Brian. Brian always has something to say. What do you think, Brian?
I think this is pretty cool.
Thank you, Brian. And how about you? You're her coach?
A lot of fun.
You proud of her? We all are. These girls are doing a tremendous job.
Yep, doing fantastic. Awesome.
Okay. Now, what we've got here, Lianna has the lead.
So it's exciting to see what happens next. Lianna's got a small lead over Alyssa. Will Alyssa keep fighting her way through, or will this be a completely different kind of story at the end? We'll have to see. And it looks like Alyssa is going to shoot first. Let's see if she gets that nice clean release again. And a little squeezing of the fingers.
Yeah, you can see those kind of curling in a little bit on her.
So in archery, in recurve archery, ideally we want the archer to pull with their back and not necessarily pull through with their fingers.
Now, is that eight that kicked out a little bit there, is that a result of that hand kicking out, maybe what they refer to as a pluck?
It looks a little bit, I mean, she does have a little bit of a pluck. You know, I want to be so gracious here in saying that clearly these young women are tremendous shooters to be
like
on this stage. So far be it from me to critique their form, but certainly I think, you know, with any archer who gets up here, once they're under pressure, flaws become readily apparent. That's what pressure does.
Alyssa.
Look at that shooting. I mean, so consistent. So even if there is a little pluck or a little squeeze, does it matter? Maybe
and
not if they're consistent with
so it.
Looks like
right.
We have that looked a little cleaner from her that time.
Absolutely. Recurve archery is really a game of consistency, as it is certainly in compound.
Three golds. Solid. Starting to relax up there now?
Not really.
Don't you love this kid? She's a pip. All right. Lianna?
Look at that.
You make a little
face.
Sight adjustment there? Or?
I'd love to know how old she is, Chuck, because she's got remarkable composure.
Yeah.
Having fun up there? Okay, very good. The arrow runners are coming back. And once again,
you know,
Alyssa,
Chuck,
you
can't help but reflect
second.
That if this was either one of us up second. There on that stage and, you know, we had an announcer asking us questions, I think we might clam up too.
Oh. Sorry.
Yeah, we might have many of the same answers. I mean, it's kind of cute to listen to her that, you know, she's got nothing to say to Rob during this thing.
No,
it is
not
kind
a word.
Of funny. She's dead. Nope. Yep. She's just up there to get it done.
But that's okay.
She shot great
that
end too.
Yeah,
she really killed it.
Doing fantastic. I mean, she's just a heck of a young shooter, and you have to wonder what are this young lady's goals, because she could certainly hold it together under the same kind of pressure that, let's face it, top archers like Mackenzie Brown and Winola Pritchard and others have faced in their national and international competition. So right through that clicker, let's see that release. Nice
beautiful.
And strong.
11.
And look at that.
Nice
an 11. Arrow. Fantastic shooting. Perfect score on that arrow.
That'll be a big swing. So now, unofficially, she's got a 4-point lead going into this arrow.
So much,
it with a nine.
Yeah, so much respect for these two young shooters under so much pressure right now and shooting their game. And
wow.
Look at that.
Back-to-back 11s.
That's fantastic shooting from her.
That'll completely swing this match. Oh, she got kicked out.
And
it was
actually
just a little.
Actually a beautiful shot from her. I mean, from a technical perspective, she really nailed
wow.
the shot. But look at that. A 33 from Lianna. Fantastic shooting.
How'd that feel?
It felt pretty good.
Can't beat that.
No.
Nice shooting. Let's all give Lianna a hand. That's rare shooting up here on the stage, folks.
A rare shooting, Chuck, and especially from someone so young. That's tough to do as a grown-up. I didn't do that at all.
I didn't do that a lot this weekend myself. That was really fantastic shooting, and you can see, man, that really spun this match. She's up by 9 points now going into the last end. If she can hold it together, you know, right now,
86 to 77.
You don't want to say it's a foregone conclusion, but that's a pretty tough hill to climb. If she comes out of the gate with another strong shot like that, then it's really going to put the pressure on.
Although, as we said before, you know, you always want, if you're going to lose a match, you want to lose to somebody, you want to lose to the best shooter on the field who's on their best day. And so whoever wins this match, they can really feel good about it tonight when they lay their head. Now look at that.
Look at that
strong
recovery.
10.
She came right back with a 10.
That was fantastic. And Lianna answers out to the 9.
So she gets a point back on that.
So maybe there's a little room here. Let's see how Alyssa does. Ooh, out to the 7.
7 to the left.
So she's aiming right here, but again, you're aiming and pulling at the same time.
We have a low 7.
Low 7.
Well.
Mm-hmm.
Time for this.
Shooting, you can see the nerves maybe kicking in a little.
Shooting a recurve bow and, you know, pulling through a clicker while you're aiming is a bit like walking and chewing gum. Only a lot harder. Chuck, as you know, I mean, there's that balance between aiming and keeping your back strong.
It is, and it's very difficult. You know, I've always had a high regard for recurve archers to be able to do what they do. They pull that weight all the way through to the end. It's not like a compound where it lets off.
Alyssa, I happen to know you've dealt with a little bit of pain in your shoulder, and you took a little bit of time off, and you're just coming back on. Are you happy with your shooting this weekend?
Yeah.
Very good. Congratulations on a very strong silver medal, second place. Let's give Alyssa a hand. Congratulations, Alyssa. Lindsey. Oh, Lianna. Sorry. Lianna. Miss Perfect on that third end. Nice shooting. That was incredible. Congratulations on the win. Let's give Lianna a hand. Okay, girls, you can step down. Congratulations. Nice shooting to both of you.
Why do the number one archers in the world choose the proven brands of True Ball Release and Excel Sights? Because they want to win.
I will prevail.
I will prevail.
I will prevail.
I will prevail.
I will prevail.